So guys, in today's video I want to try something new, try to activate my coils without using a styling techniques. So the product I'm going to be using is Kanja coil keeper. This is a coil keeper. At the same time, you can also use it to activate your coils. Yes, so I've already sectioned my hair into four, so I'm going to take a lot of quantity here. I want to try it out. If let me just know what comes out of it, because this is my first time I've used this product. I've seen it for a long time, but I've never had the opportunity to use it. So here I was trying to do the raking method, though this is a styling technique, but initially I didn't want to use a styling technique, but since the coil did not behave, so tried to use the raking method. Not really raking, just trying to see if it's gonna stay in shape. Obviously what I'm seeing is not well defined, so some part is defined, some part is not. So I decided to add more products. Let me see if that's the reason why it's not well defined. And from the look of things, I still have to keep using my hands to rake. Nah, it's not really what I want. So my hair is not just behaving, though sometimes it does define. So let me just use a styling technique. I give up. Though this is not a finger twist, but it's more like parting my hair in smaller section and just let it just stay. So it's not really the finger twist, just like get a smaller section of it and more like a forming in more better pattern. Yeah, more better pattern. That's just what I'm doing right now. There's something about my hair, is like I said, my hair is a combination of 4B and 4C. So sometimes if I just apply some product without doing much, like definitely I'm going to still do one or two techniques, but not really like in-depth techniques, it kind of behave. But some part will not, just like what you're saying now, some parts kind of behaving well, forming the coils, while some part is just not. So I'm going to do this second part and use a more, go into the styling technique. So now I give up, so I'm going to use a styling technique. I thought I was able to define my coils properly in a better pattern without doing the styling technique, but with the look of things, I give up, so I just have to do it. So you can see I'm still using the same, like pick the hair and just let it just form it coil. So just watch this video to the end, so you find out that the base are not well so defined, but the top are defined, and some part of my head, the base are well defined. So this process, I'm letting y'all know, like I have some subscribers complaining that can they just apply the product on the hair and just let your hair just coil. Yeah, not all hair type will be able to achieve that. Yeah, 2A, yeah, 2B, C, 3A, 3B, they may just like apply this product and just a little rake and it just go. Like you can see what, you can see the other side of my hair is nowhere defined, and this side, and I still use the same technique. So you can see I have different hair texture. So this video is just to let you all know you need to understand your hair, know what works for your hair. What works for Mrs. A may not work for you. Yeah, and I noticed there are so many YouTubers out there, they are actually 4B hair sisters, but they claim to be 4C. I don't know why they do that. You see them making videos, I'm a 4C hair sister, but when you a close look at the hair, you find that their hair is 4B. And I feel this is misleading, making a 4C hair sister feels like there's something wrong with their hair. Why is their hair not behaving? Girl, there's nothing wrong with your hair. When you see a real 4C sisters, you will definitely know. So a lot of YouTubers are not 4C. They have just few YouTubers who are real 4C sisters. So don't get deceived by what you see out there. Yeah, don't get deceived. So my hair is more of 4B, just a little one or two side of my hair that is 4C. I don't know why that part is so stubborn and will not want to behave. So guys, just watch this video to the end. Yeah, I have a lot of information in this video for you.
So guys, I want to give my first impression. This is my first time of using this particular styling cream. It's a coil keeper. So it's called coil keeper, but at the same time you can use it to activate your coil. So this is my first time of using it. Kangfa. So I can't really tell. It's a professional coil keeper. Max Apple Essence. Yeah. So I can't really tell where it's made of. I've known about this coil keeper for a long time, then when I was relaxed. Yeah, so I didn't have the opportunity to use it when I was relaxed. So I said, okay, now that I'm not relaxed, my hair is not relaxed, so let me try it out. So far so good. I almost exhausted, so I used a lot of it on my hair. So the reason why I was trying to pick the hair kind of, I wasn't really doing the finger twist, because in my previous video I did the finger twist when I used a Vaseline to define my coils. So today I decided to like just pick and let it define by itself. Pick, and the reason why I did that was to make the base a little bit defined. Though the base are not so defined, yeah, they are not so defined. But if I applied it, the product on my hair without trying to define the base a little bit, so the hair will kind of like clump together. And even if any coil is going to define just the top, and the base is gonna, it's not gonna look good. Yeah, it's not gonna look good. Yeah. Now in that video, I had a subscriber ask the question that not really like the product when you apply it on your hair, kind of like just define your coils without you doing anything. Yeah. So I kind of like buy her idea, because some hair texture, you don't necessarily need to do anything. You just apply it and your coil defines like perfectly well. So this hair texture, I mean, say like type 2B, type 2C, type 3A hair. Yes, you don't necessarily need to do anything. Well, at some point you may just want to do the raking. Yeah, you may want to do the raking, or you may just want to do the combing. You just want to comb it so it just like bounce and the coil defines well. And even down to type 3B, you can just do the raking and it's kind of like bounce. But when it goes down to type 3C, 4A, 4B, you definitely need to use a particular technique to make those coils defined properly. Though type 3B, 3C, down to 4A, when you use a particular styling technique, it has a perfect styling technique you use for them. You don't really need to stress yourself so much to make it defined. But for type 4B, which is where I fall in, type 4B, type 4C, because on part of my hair, the coils are tight. But I have major of 4B, yeah, a little of 4C in my hair. I think at the middle part of my hair, so the coils there is tight, kind of. I'm very, very stubborn. Yeah, 4B and 4C sisters, you may have to like do put in a little bit effort to define those coils properly. Just like what I did today, I applied this product. If it's type 2A, if it's type 2A, 3A, 3B, immediately they apply that product, just raking it, and you find that the coils are just like popping out. Yes, but for our own texture, we love our hair, so we have to discover that perfect technique that suits your hair texture. You just don't apply this product and just let it like, it's not possible. Please don't mind the chicken crying out there. So this is festive period, Christmas period, so a lot of chicken everywhere. Everybody's like still in this celebration mood. Add a little bit effort to give you that perfect definition, coil definition, that will make the base, the roots look good. Yeah, so that is where we fall in. And something I've discovered is you look at what you have, make good use of what you have. Yes, don't try to be Mr. A. Because I saw some of the comments in my comment section in some of my videos, I saw some black ladies saying, oh, they wish they have white ladies' hair. Come on, girl, why are you saying that? I'm not saying you should not appreciate other people's hair texture. I'm not saying you should not like feel like having their own hair texture. But in that comment, she felt, her comments to me is kind of feeling bitter in the sense that she never liked her hair for a bit. And I tried to reply her to tell her like, girl, please appreciate your hair. Fine, it's good to appreciate other people's hair texture, But your hair, you need to appreciate it, because whatever hair texture you have to make good use of it. Good use of it, like making it look good and make it presentable. You can't say because you have 4C or 4D hair, you want to look like the whole world is against you. Or maybe your creator did something bad for giving you that kind of hair texture. No. Just as we preach, love your skin color, love your skin complexion, love your skin tone. So we also need to preach, love your hair texture, love your hair texture, because that is what your creator gave it to you. You have to love it. Yes. So that comes to the end of my video for today. I hope you like this video. If you love this video, give it a thumbs up. If there's any comment you have to say about my video, maybe the styling technique, the curling technique I use, you don't like it or you like it, please drop your comment. If you have any question, any collaboration, I'm always ready for you. Please drop your comment in the comment section. I will see you in my next video.